Infinite Godstone of Riddle. What are we doing? We just left our homes because suddenly there were threats. Probably shouldn't be looking to me for advice. Look at these people. Somebody has to hold them together. That's you, Rook. How am I supposed to do that? Lie? Tell them everything's going to be alright? Gods, Rook, I don't know. Pretend you know what you are doing. That's what the rest of us do. That could work. Thanks for the advice. Then do whatever you want. Let them fend for themselves. You can live with it. You humans are absurd, Rook. Curious when you are not in control. Terrified when you are. Pull it together. I'm worried about Alette mostly. Keep her close. You care, I can tell. Men are plague on the world worse than any dredge, as far as I can tell. Chats like these are why we get along so well, Ivor. You sleep poorly. The sun forever stuck. An eternally bright sky. Before the others rise, you find yourself staring over long, low hills covered in pine. The Godstone looms overhead. Massive eyes of Hyrvalof looking at the same direction as you. Inspect the stone. The weathered stone doesn't see many visitors. Not much reason to travel so far east. When hunters come through, they sometimes stop to give offerings out of habit. More than anything else now that gods are dead. Irvalur was the god of hunters and of wild beasts, occasionally seen roaming the land as both man and wolf. He was always depicted in effigy with his terrible spear. You wonder what he'd think about his woods being full of dredge now. A young girl from the caravan approaches you. I made this for you, Chase, handing you a crude necklace carved from a branch she must have found nearby. Thank you for saving my mama, she says, before running back to her tent. Back at your tent, you rose, Alette. Rose arose, who clings to your arm until he is completely awake. Bad dreams. Eventually the camp is broken down and it's time to move on to Frostfell. It feels like an end more than a start. Jarkenrun. Well? Don't really have that much supplies. Hopefully we meant, you know, it's enough. Caravan halts when a group of men appear on the trail, weapons at their feet. You've seen the dredge in your wake, says one. We don't wish to meet them alone. You let us join you, we'll show you a watering hole with enough animals to fill those supply wagons. An inherent fear of strangers raises mutters from the caravan. Let's ask them, what are you doing here, out here alone? We were hunting here for food when the dredge found our village, says the man. When we returned, he looks away, unable to finish. Well, what harm they can do? Let's let them join. If you'll be no trouble, come along, you say. The men cautiously join your ranks and prove trustworthy. The hidden watering hole nearby is teeming with animals and soon your supplies are nicely restocked. Do during a rest, one of the men get too drunk and end up splashing mead in a warrior's face. A brawl erupts. Many thrown fists and broken bone later. The instigator, what's with these names? Ravnsvart is tossed on the ground at your feet, angry clansmen looking for satisfaction. His personal defense is little more than a drooling mumbles. Encourage the others to let the issue drop. We are all on edge, he replied to the crowd. Does anyone here not deserve a strong drink right now? Let him walk it off. The caravan mutters in lukewarm agreement and gets ready to travel again. Could have gone worse, you think? I think a lot. The caravan is visibly relieved to find a small village on the way to Frostwell. With beds and fresh supplies, the locals here are shocked by the news you bring and discuss it amongst themselves while you set up nearby. Oh, nice. Village. Let's see our heroes. Item. Dodge strong attacks. Yeah, that's bad. I like that. He's going to name him. No, that's our new order. Well, let's go talk to him. Eagle. Or the arm eagle. We find Eagle outside the camp practicing his words wings. Now this could have gone before we asked about the arm. I saw you taking some hard hits out there. Oh yeah, I'm great. Not great. Considering everything that's... I'm fine. My arm's fine, it's a strong shield. It's true, right? I know we haven't talked much before now. But if you want, just call me Jill. Okay, Jill. I wanted to let you know that I meant what I said before. About making sure nothing happens to Alet. Think about what to say. I've never seen a shield like that before. Yeah, I doubt there's many. My father made this. It's solid metal, really heavy. But I've been practicing with it since I was a kid. I used to spend a lot of time just getting used to lifting it. He raises it up and to show you, I'm pretty good with it now. It's the only thing of my father's I have left. Then, when my mother died, she gave it to me before she died. You are protective of Alette, huh? Well, I don't want her to get hurt. You can see his cheeks turn bright red. Don't worry, she can take care of herself too. So wait, we are her father? Or brother. Did I miss something? I know, I didn't mean... Easy, Jill. I know what you meant, you dirty bastard. Yeah, I know what you mean. Did he say that? It's good, I'm trying. Never had to fight anything like Dredge before, but... I don't have much else to do, and now, and how many people get to train with the war? Just seems like I could be help to someone. That's what I want to be. I'm heading back to camp. Stay strong. I will. Oh, and if you need something, let me know. I can do anything you need. Between you and Ivor, we are going to be okay, I can tell. Hopefully. Let's see. There's the map. So, that's where we need to go. Once sitting up on the bank of White Lake when Nordfelling turned to waste, the city of Frostwell became a tethered bastion blasted by freezing winds that rolled through the valley. Those who live here still are not known for their hospitality. And yet we are going there. Good. So, minus one drawing aggro. Unusual carved stone is warm to be to touch, and holding it fills you with steely resolve. That could be good. She doesn't draw aggro. So yeah, we don't need to rest, so we can just leave. And continue to... We are only just outside the village when two men in red approach. My name is Hogun, says one, gesturing to the other. My brother is Mogun. Hogun and Mogun, well, oh. And many from the village wish to join you to Frostwell. The third man, shooting rage, charges up to the group. Shut your mouth, Hogun, he screams. What's going on? These bastards don't speak for us. They've been trying to divide the village since you've got here. True, you can keep whoever wants to stay and die. The rest of us will go with the reasonable people of Skugger. I'll have you both gathered before I left. Let half the village desert. Behind the angry villager, a mob of armed thugs have appeared, all full of brows and nervous stares. You both know what will happen to the rest of us if the fields are abandoned. Nobody leaves. Well, there won't be anything to dent, that's for sure. Wretch my ass. I don't know what the scam this time, Ogun, but you got two choices. Get back to work or I'm finally putting you in the ground. Ogun, what do you say? But it was unfair that he only asked me. Ogun draws his axe slowly, followed by Ogun. Despite their confidence, the brothers are significantly outnumbered. I think I make a poor farmer. Should we chat with the brothers or the villagers? This is tough. Let's see now. Or to not get involved.